closer we get to it, the more exciting it becomes and the more you realise like what you'll be doing, what you're gaining from it. And
I want to climb the rigging. I want to give that a go.
It's a really, really big challenge because I can't swim. So the whole idea of going out onto the sea terrifies me a little bit.
80% of the people that sail never sail again. But every one of them say, fantastic. Gained a lot from it. Self-confidence, self-esteem.
Since I've sailed on here, I've met some people who I speak to every single day and who've become best friends.
Very first time, I've never sailed before. Most I've ever done is ferry across the channel.
I think it's going to be just ridiculously exciting just to be out on the sea and stuff.
My name's Peter Elson and I'm the Liverpool Echo shipping correspondent. We're surrounded by tall ships here in Albert and Canning docks, and it's a beautiful place in which to start off an adventure like this.
We all know what shifts we're doing and what watches we're doing. Just waiting to get out and hit the water, I think the word is.
Being in that ship environment, you can't be an individual. You can't pull a rope on your own. You have to work together as part and parcel of the team. You have to communicate.
When I'm down below deck, when I get the occasional wave rocking the boat a little bit, I'm sort of going, you know, I'm going to be able to handle it when we actually get out to sea and it's rocking constantly.
This is one of the biggest things probably I've ever put them on. They have done small outward bound courses, but sailing the ship is going to be a big challenge towards them.
Being up on deck, either at 4 o'clock in the morning or 8 o'clock at night, and just looking out and seeing nothing but water, it's that feeling that you're free and you've got no worries and no stresses and nothing can bother you, and it's just such a relaxing feeling.
We've had a great couple of briefings today from the guys on board, and it's now starting to dawn on them that this isn't going to be a holiday, it's going to be hard work. You've absolutely got to respect the boat and you've got to respect each other.
Being here actually on the boat, it's such a different feeling. Like, in less than 25 hours we're going to be sailing it, and it's going to be so weird because there's only 3 permanent crew and the rest are apprentices who have never done sailing before. We're all going to be trusted on this boat with all these different roles. It's going to be weird, but it'll be exciting.
That transformation that goes in front of your eyes in 7 days is quite incredible. It's watching their confidence grow. That's the main thing. It's changing that ability of I can't do this to I can.
The buzz that's going on down there in the galley at the moment as they go through that training is just amazing. And, you know, it's quite clear that they're going to take something from the next week, and that's really going to benefit our business and the growth at Pilports Group.
like everybody gets seasick, so don't worry about it.
The best thing about sail training is sort of pushing people to do something they may not be entirely comfortable with initially, like climbing the rigging. Once they've done it one time, two times, you know, they'll be up there in a flash. As soon as they get down on deck, the smiles on their faces is just testament to a job well done.
So it's the nervous ones we like the best because they hold on the tightest, so it's good to see them nice and nervous, but they'll be flying by the end of the week and they'll be tearing up it.
David Hook, Port Director for the Port of Liverpool. And it's a real pleasure just to see the enthusiasm and knowing full well that the team will get an awful lot out of this next week. These guys and girls are our future leaders. In another 5 years they're going to be running and maintaining some of the best port operating equipment in Europe, and Pilports Group are absolutely delighted to be sponsoring this event.
We've got roughly 200 young people now sailing on four different ships, competing against each other around the whole of the Irish Sea. And next year it's going to be even bigger because the Irish apprentices want to come, the Dutch apprentices want to come, the French apprentices want to come. We can make Liverpool the tall ship centre for the North. That means the Northwest will get involved with us. We then become stronger instead of just Liverpool. The river is the DNA, my DNA, fact. And this city turned its back on the river. It's now realising the wealth of what the river can bring in the way of businesses. So we attract the Northwest to come to Liverpool because we have a tourism in the way of tall ships. And Whitehaven's the other one. Belfast is another one. So we're talking about these great links across the Irish Sea. So we can make this whole area attractive for people to come. Wow, that's business, because it brings money into the city. It brings tourists into the city.
Since I got on the boat, I've just been sort of jumping at the bit, ready to go.
I just want to get going, get some work done. I want to feel what it's like on the boat.
And I look forward to the Apprentice Ship Cup just getting bigger and better every year. Jim has now got interest from the Netherlands and Denmark, maybe France and Ireland, who want to join in, which bodes very well indeed. It should be bigger and better next year, and it's going to help put Liverpool back on the map.
My gut feeling, my absolute bottom line on this, is that these young people have got a great opportunity with their employer. This tall ship race gives them an opportunity and an experience they will never forget.
Once it was up there, it was amazing. You could see how far around you could see. I didn't think it was going to be as high as it actually was when we first got up. But by the time you're hanging over, and the adrenaline just kicks in there.
Complexity of the ropes. I didn't think it would be so intricate to sail a boat. I didn't think it would be this complicated. I thought it'd be easier than this.
I've enjoyed every minute of it, to be honest. It's been an eye-opening experience.
Working in a small space all together, so you've got to learn to live with each other and get along, really.
You're thrown in the deep end, aren't you?
A lot of visuals, beautiful visuals, and that made a lot of friends.
It's the lads that you go with, you make the trip, really. There's a really good banter going around that was really funny. We had the crew members who were already there. They were all a good laugh, so it really made the trip a lot easier with everyone getting on really well with each other.
I've learned a lot of things. It's built confidence, developed my team working skills, and my ability to communicate in stressful situations. So when we did the man overboard exercise, it was quite stressful, but it was really good fun at the same time. Just everyone running all over the place on the ship to turn the ship round in time before the person drowned.
Liverpool, it's been great working with you. Yeah, it's been a pleasure. Look forward to working with you again. Proves that we can work as a strong team and we get the job.
Yeah, thank you, Frank from Glendale.
Definitely a confidence boost. The crew that we've had on, temporary crew, I think they've come out of the shelves a bit as well. I think Kieran is a bit of a quiet lad, but you can see through the journey he's a lot more talkative.
I think they learn a lot about themselves, inner feelings, inner thoughts.
These youngsters have developed in front of our eyes in a very fast-paced fashion this week.
I went up when we had the full sail up. It was intense. It was very intense. I used to be scared of heights, to be honest. So it's a bit of a push for me to get up there, but I managed it, touched the top of the mast, and I enjoyed it.
I come on board and was seasick for the first 3 days of the voyage and couldn't get out of bed. After them 3 days, I haven't just had the time of my life. I loved every second of it.
Life-changing. It's a life-changing experience.
I think when we hit the swells just outside the Isle of Man, the bow was literally just like that. One minute you were looking into the sea and the next minute you were looking into the sky. It was like a fairground ride. But as I say, I found that quite fun. I quite enjoyed that. Some people didn't.
The entire day, I was just being sick. I couldn't keep water down. I couldn't keep anything down. But for that was the worst part, but it was also sort of the best part because it made things a bit more challenging, like still cracked on with the watches and everything that needed to be done. So it was the worst part, but also the best part in sort of a weird way.
It was hard going, lack of sleep. There's a lot of hard work to go on, a lot of tacking, which basically changed the direction of the sails, which hands got all blistered. It didn't really seem like work at the time, it was all a good laugh because it was new. So everyone was just sort of enjoying it, taking it as it came. I thought I'd really struggle with this, lack of sleep, a lot of hard work, a lot of physical work, but I learned that I'm capable of more than what I thought, you know. You're more comfortable because at first you feel a lot of pressure because obviously you're out on the water and if you make too many mistakes or, you know, anything could happen really, but towards the end of it you start to feel more confident with yourself, taking a bit more of a leadership role on the helm, steering, you know. It's quite strict to stick to, you don't want to go off course too much, and by the end of it you just think, you know what, I'm not going to panic too much and I'm just going to get on with it. And you do, and everyone done well, so I think a lot more people came confident.
Because there's stuff here that, you know, you have to do it yourself and you do have to pull that rope, or, you know, and you might not be entirely sure you're on the right rope, but you have to pull it, and then you find out that you are and you've got it right and all your doubts disappear.
You know, you've got to stick together as a big group, and I think a lot of people were confident of each other more than anything as well, so and that was all good.
You get to know who can do what and
on the ship, yeah.
Yeah, and you know who needs help with what and who can be left to go.
You see people in groups and their peers who come across as the strong ones, and then as soon as the seas start to roll and the boat starts to rock, actually what might be perceived to be the weaker ones in the team start supporting the ones who are feeling ill.
So that journey for me was quite incredible. The staff and the crew were great, very supportive of all that. And everything that he said, he did deliver. I'm reflecting on it now. It achieved things that I couldn't imagine. It was absolutely fantastic. And everything that was publicised about the experience, you know, in terms of team building, communication, developing social skills, all those things, I seen it firsthand.
The thing that surprised me really was that the crew let us do stuff. I was expecting us to sort of stand there and watch, but it was the other way around. They stood there and watched us do it all and told us to do it. The fact that they trusted us to actually sail their ship, that was probably the best thing for it.
I'd say the most memorable thing is making friends.
I've really enjoyed doing it. I'd definitely do it again if I can. If anyone is thinking about doing it, I would heartily suggest that they do, because it is a really, really good experience.
From an employer who invests in apprentices, to take these group of people away from the job for a week was absolutely fantastic value for money. And a lot of our guys, I can see them growing in confidence even since that week. So for me, Jim, I'm signed up to next year anyway, and I'd hope to do a lot more with you.
2015, the tow ships race and the Apprentice Ship Cup challenge will be huge. I'm being told it is huge. Some companies have sat back, fools to them. We came forward, United Utilities and Sellafield, and we've put the sort of marker down. We'll be back next year to challenge anybody who wants to join us. Yeah.